Hi, this is Christina from theguardianindianmom.com. So today's video is going to be on schedules and rest. So for me, basically, I am a person who's very scheduled because I feel it saves a lot of my sanity, and I think it's also a little genetic because my grandfather and my father are both very scheduled and organized people. So I guess that's where it comes for me too. So for me, I really prefer things to be scheduled, and I've really seen the benefits of that in my own life because there is a time and place for everything. And I feel like having a schedule helps to keep things intact. Like suppose when things get delayed, suppose breakfast was to get delayed, then study time would get delayed, and then lunch would get delayed, and then dinner time would get delayed, and then sleep time would get delayed. So this this thing of keep on pushing things downstream, and then you tend to miss out things. So for that reason, I feel schedules are really good. And also keeping a time for everything. There's a time for play, there's a time for watching TV, there's a time for doing your own thing, and there's a time for study. Having good a set time helps children also to be less to throw less tantrums, because they know what to expect. They know, like, at this time they're supposed to study, they're ready, and you just have to ask them, what time is it? It's time to study. So they would just come and sit down and study, and then they know when it's time for them to watch TV, and they would be doing that. So I just feel it avoids a lot of conflict and keeps the house peaceful when we do follow schedules to a limit. Now, people would ask, how strictly would you follow schedule? Schedules are a guidelines. You cannot follow them to a T. I mean, no person could ever follow every single thing to a single T. You will never be able to do it. No human can do that. But it is good to have a set of guidelines and follow it as much as you can, so that you can keep everything moving smoothly, you don't miss out things, and you have a peaceful household. So for that reason, I really do believe schedules are really helpful, and they've been really helpful for our family. Now, the second thing that I wanted to talk about is rest. I really believe in the 8-hour sleep, because when we are well rested, our mind, our brain and our mind works really well, and it's fresh, so it can absorb a lot of things. So in our house, we really follow sleep time very religiously. At 9, my boys go down to sleep. Maximum 9:30, but not more than that. One or two days in a year, they would probably be lax. They would go to sleep by 10. But that would have been, again, a very rare scenario. But we do follow sleep time very religiously, because sleep, a child that has slept well, it will be less stressed, and will be, you know, will be less likely to throw tantrums, because they're already tired and fatigued, and when we ask them to do something, or if they're expecting something out of them, they're not going to be happy to do that. So for that reason, I really believe a child should be well rested. So in our house, we really try to stick to our sleep time and make sure our kids get their 8 hours of sleep. So that is like our number one priority in our house. So this is it from me on schedules and sleep time. Until next time, see you. Bye.